Hello, my friends. Welcome to my review on the LORAC I Love Brunch palette. So sit back, relax, grab your mimosa, and let's get to talking about some makeup. If you've never been to one of my reviews before, they are quite long and involved. So if you would like to skip ahead to a specific portion of the video, there will be timestamps, clickable links down below for you to find exactly what you're looking for. We're gonna start with the fact that this is right now, to my knowledge, only available at Ulta. I believe it is available in Ulta stores as well as Ulta.com. This is made in the United States, but some of the ingredients are made outside of the United States. So as far as this being cruelty-free, LORAC does have a statement on their website saying that they are cruelty-free. But then they also make the statement that they do not apply for cruelty-free status with like Leaping Bunny and places like that because they cannot guarantee that the suppliers of their suppliers are not cruelty-free. So they feel a moral obligation not to apply for those programs. So depending on your level of cruelty-freeness, you may say LORAC is cruelty-free. You may say that you don't know if LORAC is cruelty-free and decide not to purchase from them. I will link an article down below by Cruelty Free Kitty about her opinion on this issue. This is, however, not a vegan product because some of the shadows may or may not include an ingredient called carmine, which is made from beetles. So this would not be for the vegans out there. By the way, the eyeshadow primer that does come with this is also not vegan. It does have beeswax in it. Along with the eyeshadow palette, you do get a dual-sided brush. One is a little bit shorter, a little more dense, and one is quite fluffy. I would imagine this would be for packing color on the lid, even though I do feel like it's a bit round for packing on the lid, and I wish that the taper went down a little bit more, but I do like this as a fluffy blending brush. It's a little bit long, but it's dense enough, and it's stiff enough that you can really work the shadow and actually enjoy using it. This LORAC behind the scenes eye primer deluxe sample, this isn't my favorite primer. I don't find that it works better than my Urban Decay, better than my Ulta brand. I do happen to like those better than this. I don't feel like this is quite as effective. It's not a bad primer, it's just not my favorite. Within this palette, you do get 16 eyeshadows. 8 of them are shimmer and 8 of them are matte, but unlike some LORAC palettes, they are mixed through. Some LORAC palettes are, you know, they've got all the shimmer all together and then all the mattes all together. They have chosen not to do that. They're kind of mixed through. There's no shadows in here that I feel like they call a shimmer but aren't really shimmer, except for this one here that's called Eggs Benny. This one has some glitter in it, some actual silver glitter in it. This one has some very, very, maybe some fine glitter in it, but not, it's really fine if we're gonna call that glitter. That one's called Pancakes. It's more of a satiny, shimmery shade. Same thing with Bloody Mary, just very, very fine, fine sparkle in there, but Eggs Benny has some significant sparkle in it. The rest are more of like a satiny kind of finish. They're definitely not foiled in any way. They just have kind of a shine, a sheen to them. This palette is $44. It contains 13.6 grams of product, making it $3.24 per gram of product. That's if you don't count the brush and the primer as part of the value. If you're just saying that those are bonus, those don't count. This eyeshadow palette isn't the best value. It's not a terrible value. It's kind of like in the middle to a little more expensive when you compare it to brands like Too Faced, Urban Decay, palettes like that that I see as being kind of similar price point brands. It's really not the best value, but again, it's not terrible. Now, I did buy one of the blushes as well. That's kind of a little bonus review we're throwing in for you. There are two blushes in this line. This one is called Luma. This was the one that stood out to me as one that I wanted to try. This blush is $23. It contains 5.1 grams of product, equaling out to $4.51 per gram. Again, kind of middle of the road to a little bit expensive. Compared to some other blushes that are in kind of the same price range, we have the Amazonian 12-Hour Clay blushes. Those are $4.94 per gram. The NARS blushes are $6.61 per gram. The Too Faced Papa Don't Peach is $3.31. Their eyeshadow palettes are less per gram as well. And the IT Cosmetics Radiant Ombre blush is $2.23 per gram, so that is the least expensive. So this one's kind of in the middle to a little expensive, just like the palette. So now my very favorite part of the review, the swatches. I'm gonna go ahead and show those to you now. So let's go ahead and look at those now.
All right, here is the I Love Brunch palette. We're gonna start with the first row, lavender, eggs benny, gluten-free, and hot sauce. So lavender was probably the lamest choice to put first because it's definitely by far the weakest shade in the palette. It doesn't swatch well, it doesn't work well, it's not good. Eggs benny is just okay. Gluten-free is my favorite in this row. And hot sauce is actually also a really good shade. It doesn't swatch great, but it's a good shade. So you can see in the brush swatch how weak lavender is. It's pretty terrible. Eggs benny could be good, but there just isn't enough pigment in there. There's a little bit of sparkle, but it kind of falls away when you actually use it. Now here's just evidence of the awesomeness of gluten-free. And then hot sauce is a good shade. It's not a great shade, but it's a good shade. It does what it's supposed to do in a very light, easy way. And then this is the entire first row. It's my least favorite row overall, but gluten-free is definitely the star here. Now moving on to the wipe test. The reason for the wipe test is to show you what happens when you kind of overblend the shadows, what may happen if you try to wear them all day, which shadows are gonna last the longest. And as you can see, hot sauce is the only one that really truly sticks around. So just be careful when you're blending these shadows on this row, because if you overblend, they are going to disappear. Next, moving on to the second row, jelly donut, pancakes, sorbet, and valet. Again, another row that isn't fantastic, but it's definitely better than the first row. Jelly donut is very nice as a brow bone shade. It's got a lot of opacity to it for packing on the lid. It is a nice color. You can see with the brush swatch, the jelly donut really is a nice shade. You'd be able to see it even better on a deeper skin tone. Pancakes, on the other hand, is a little bit weak. It's okay, it's just a little powdery, and I don't know, it's not my favorite. Sorbet, I actually really, really like, even though it's not swatching the best here. It's a very nice transition shade on me, believe it or not, and I do enjoy it. Valet is another really weak, powdery shade. It just doesn't show up anywhere and it fades really fast. So this is row two altogether. And as you can see, there really isn't a lot of color happening here. Sorbet is the only one you can even really see that much on my skin tone. But I would say the winners from this row are Jelly Donut and Sorbet. And I'm wiping very lightly here, and you can see that sorbet is the only one that really sticks around. You have a little bit of valet, surprisingly, but I had a really hard time working with valet on the lid. Now this third row is my favorite row in the palette. They're all good, if not great, shadows. First we have Bloody Mary, then Blueberry Scone, then Moonlight, and then Avocado Toast, which is my absolute favorite shade in this palette. It is really fun to play with. Bloody Mary kind of blends out. It's not a great shade. It's not bad, but it's kind of hard to work with in that sparkle that's there doesn't really stay around. Blueberry Scone is a very nice shade. It's very mild, soft blue. So if you wanted a little bit of blue without it being too loud, Blueberry Scone's a nice shade. Moonlight is a nice brightening shade, but I wish it was just a little bit brighter. I wish it had the intensity of gluten-free, but in that yellow kind of buttery buttercup kind of color. And of course, Avocado Toast. Oh, it's just so pretty. It'll give you a nice pop of color without being so incredibly overpowering. So again, this row is my absolute favorite. I really, really like it a lot. And for the wipe test, you can see that these all hang around pretty well, except for Moonlight that fades away. One thing I appreciate about these shadows is they do stay true to their color when they start fading away. They don't change to brown or gray as you wipe them, which is great. Moving into that bottom row, we have Mimosa, Smoothie, French Toast, and Sunday Funday. Mimosa is my absolute favorite shade in this row. I really like it. It's very opaque, very bright. Smoothie, they nailed it on the shimmery purple. I wish that they had been able to do that with the matte purple, but the shimmery purple, at least, it definitely holds true to that color, really nice and pigmented. French Toast ends up not performing well on the lid. It ends up being almost like a wash of color rather than an opaque color. So it definitely is one of my least favorite shades in the palette. And then Sunday Funday swatches really bad, but it actually can perform very nicely on the eye, especially if you pair it with hot sauce or Bloody Mary. It'll kind of beef up those shades. On its own, it does look pretty weak. So overall with this row, the only big win is Mimosa, followed very closely by Smoothie, French Toast, and Sunday Funday, just kind of eh. Now with the wipe test, you'll see that these hang out pretty well considering that they're not super deep shades. I'm actually quite impressed. Mimosa hangs out the best, and all the rest just kind of fade a little bit, but not completely.
Now you have seen the swatches of the palette. Let's go ahead and go into the demo of how I got this look today.
Can't you see that it's just raining? There ain't no need to go outside. But baby, you hardly even notice when I try to show you. Song is meant to keep you doing what you're supposed to. Waking up too early, maybe we could sleep. Make you banana pancakes, pretend like it's the weekend now. We could pretend it all the time, yeah. Can't you see that it's just raining? There ain't no need to go outside. But just maybe, like a ukulele, mama made a baby. Really don't mind the practice, cause you're my little lady. Lady, lady, love me, cause I love to lay you lazy. We could close the curtains, pretend like there's no world outside. Then we could pretend it all the time, Lord. And can't you see that it's just raining? There ain't no need to go outside. Ain't no need, ain't no need. Can't you see, can't you see? Rain all day and I don't mind. But the telephone's singing, ringing, it's too early, don't pick it up. We don't need to, we got everything we need right here, and everything we need is enough. Just so easy when the whole world fits inside of your arms. Really need to pay attention to the alarm. Wake up slow. Wake up slow. But baby, you hardly even notice when I try to show you this. Song is meant to keep you from doing what you're supposed to. Waking up too early, maybe we could sleep. Make you banana pan.
Now it's time, ladies and gentlemen, for ingredient analysis. This is when I go to EWG or environmentalworkinggroup.org and other websites that I trust to tell you about ingredients that are in these products and whether you need to be careful of anything with the ingredients. So we're going to start with the eyeshadow palette and then we're going to talk about the blush. The first thing I want to let you know is that 15 out of the 16 shades do have the same ingredients in the same order. The one that is different is the shade Moonlight. That one does not have carmine listed as a possible ingredient. And then there's this ingredient that I cannot pronounce. I'm not even going to try. That is also in the Moonlight, but is not in the other 15 shades. That one has no ingredient concerns. It's just different. It's a silicone-based binding agent, so maybe they just had more trouble with that one kind of sticking together and being a solid pressed shadow, and maybe that's why they used it. That's my speculation. So, big shocker, first ingredient in this palette is talc. Talc can be irritating to some people. There's also some data gaps for talc, things that we just don't know about talc. The next one is ethylhexyl palmitate, which is another one that's not a big shocker. It's pretty much in every single eyeshadow palette. It's a derivative of palm oil, and basically it's an allergen to some people. Next one is something called propylene glycol. It's a skin conditioning agent. There's conflicting statements about some irritation concerns, but Polish Choice says there's no concern when it comes to cosmetics. Potassium sorbate is a preservative, also irritation concerns. And then with the pigments, the yellow colorant is the same one we see in a lot of eyeshadow eyeshadow palettes. It is lip safe according to the FDA, but there's mixed data as to whether or not this ingredient is bioaccumulative, meaning it can build up in your system, by scientists in Canada. The amount used in a product is regulated in the European Union. And then the last one is another colorant, which is called ultramarines, and the ultramarines are not lip safe. So make sure you're not putting these shadows on your lips. I don't know which ones absolutely contain ultramarines. There's no real way to know. According to the ingredient list, it looks like they could all possibly contain ultramarines. So just be safe and don't put them on your lips. Now with the blush, a lot of the ingredients that were in the eyeshadow are also in the blush. So you can cross-reference that. I'll also put that down in the description below. But there is an ingredient in this that is not in the eyeshadow palette, and that is the retinol palmitate, and it is listed as a 9 on Environmental Working Group, which is a really, really high score. Very rarely do I see anything above a 5 in an ingredient. It is a skin condition agent, and it's a form of vitamin A. So the big concern about this ingredient is that it's sometimes contained in sunscreens, and there is some evidence to support that it actually causes skin sensitivity to sunlight. So I'm not sure how big of a deal it would be in a blush. I'm just gonna read what the website, I'll link it down below, says. It says, may speed the development of skin tumors and lesions when applied to the skin in the presence of sunlight. It is a known human reproductive toxin. It's banned or found unsafe in cosmetics in Germany. One or more animal studies showed tumor formation in low doses because it does absorb into the skin. Now, Polish Choice says that this is absolutely not true, that what they did was they tested this particular ingredient on rats, and they tested it in full concentration, and the rats had tumors. So the amount of that ingredient that is in a powder blush is probably insignificant compared to what it was on the rats that made it seem like this was something that was really, really bad and shouldn't be in any cosmetics. So they say they're based on a study from nearly 20 years ago that has never been reproduced or tested under real life conditions, such as how people use sunscreens that contain this ingredient. Also on Polish Choice website, it says that the Skin Cancer Foundation's Photobiology Committee stated that there's no scientific evidence that retinol palmitate causes cancer in humans. So, but I do want to put it out there just in case that freaks you out. This is definitely not something you want to purchase. So now on to my full review. So let's start with the eyeshadow palette. There's some bright spots. there's some ones in here that aren't bad. I think what it comes down to is that about half this palette is not good at all. Like this shade right here, lavender, I don't know what they were thinking making this the very first shade, because it's the worst shade in the palette. You can see in the swatches, it doesn't show it up at all. But then you have some gems like avocado toast, which is my absolute favorite in here. I also really love mimosa. I really love sorbet. I really love gluten free. There are some fantastic shades in here. I bought this knowing it was going to be a supplemental palette, meaning that I was going to have to pull from other palettes in order to make this work, because there really are no mid-tone or deep shades. I wish that they had gotten rid of either Hot Sauce, Bloody Mary, or Sunday Funday and done a deep dark chocolate color to at least give us something to deepen the look, to give some kind of dimension. There's just nothing there. A shade that I absolutely love, though, I have to tell you about, is Guilt Free. Guilt Free is one where if you do a matte look with this and you want to just shimmer it up, you can layer Guilt Free over top and it'll give them all this beautiful shimmer and shine. I really, really love that shade. I wish Eggs Benny, I wish that the glitter that shows up in Eggs Benny and the swatches actually stayed on the eyes. Unfortunately, a lot of these shadows will fade away if you overblend them. If you're trying to work with multiple shadows, you have to keep going back and forth and back and forth and back and forth between the shadows to get them to show up and be true to color. But that being said, I can see some people really enjoying this palette, especially people that like nice, calm color. Unfortunately, there's so many shades in here that are duds that I really can't recommend it to you as a palette. I just can't. It's not good. Some people have been asking me to compare this to the Pastel Goth. I do have a live swatch session that I did impromptu when I unboxed this that I will link down below, but I'll show you just very quickly. The Pastel Goth by Kat Von D was another another pastel palette that came out recently, and you can see right away the difference in the brightness of the shadows. I mean, there's just no comparison, and these will give you this kind of color payoff. These, they look pastel. These are not true pastels, in my opinion. They're more just very bright, neon, lighter toned shades. If you don't like this because it's too bright, you might like some of the shades in here. But it does break my heart that so many of them are just not good shadows. I do feel like that they're improving on their pastel green. They did have the mint edition palette that came out a while back, and this avocado toast is so much better than the mint shade that was in that palette. So I'm really happy that they improved it. I think that because of avocado toast and because of mimosa and a couple of other shades in here, I'm probably going to keep this palette, but kind of reluctantly, because I don't think it's worth $44 at all. I do want to show this to you. This is the LORAC California Dreaming palette. This is actually not my palette. This belongs to my friend Meredith. She's a tattoo artist at our tattoo studio. She loves makeup just as much as I do, which is fantastic to have conversations with her. She's also a wonderful artist. I will link her Instagram down below in case you want to check her tattoos out. But this palette, I did swatch it, but I have not put it on my eyes because it doesn't belong to me. But I really find the shade selection in here to be a lot more interesting as far as the amount of looks you can get, the pigmentation of it. It just seems like a better overall palette as far as the shade range. Again, I haven't used it personally. Meredith seems to really like it. Reviews seem to be really going on it. So just from my limited experience with this, if you're going to pick one of the two to try LORAC eyeshadows, I would recommend the California Dreaming over this. The price per gram is a little cheaper with this, but you're also not getting the brush and the primer, so that may make a difference to you. So final thoughts on the palette. I feel like it's good intended. I feel like they missed the mark. And lastly, just a quick review on the blush. I would be very hesitant to put this on someone of a medium to deeper skin tone because it is extremely pastel. And I did put this on my friend that is of Filipino descent. She has a medium olivey skin tone, and I put it on her hand. I was like, give me your hand, Jenny. And I grabbed her hand and kind of put it on her hand. And she was like, what are you doing? She's amazing though. She laughed. She thought it was funny. She said I could use her hand anytime. But anyway, so when I blended it out on her, it kind of blended into her skin tone, and it really wasn't flattering on her. It looked very powdery, where with me, I feel like it goes on my cheeks. You can see it, but it's a very subtle color. So if you like a really subtle blush with a little bit of a glow, you'll probably really love this. Lasting power is pretty good on it. It lasts me good through a good 6 to 8 hours, which is wonderful for a blush. Oh, I forgot to mention lasting power with this is okay. It just really depends on what shadows you use, whether you use the good ones or the bad ones. If you use the good ones, it's gonna last a lot longer than if you use the bad ones. It's not going to lose a lot, you know, last very long. If you look at the swatches, the ones that tend to wipe away, those don't last as long as the ones that have more pigmentation that seem to last more on my arm. It's very true to the wipe test, so use that as a reference. But it does give a little bit of a glow, so if you have textured skin, you may like it, you may not. It may accentuate your pores. I didn't find it accentuated my pores on my face, but I don't have large pores, so I can't really speak to that. If you like a lot of pop, a lot of pigment in your blush, you won't like this. If you want something more natural that you really can't mess up, you might actually really like this blush, even though it's getting terrible reviews online. So that's my review of the LORAC I Love Brunch collection. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, definitely make sure you hit the subscribe button and the thumbs up button because it makes me look super cool. And watch another video if you want. You'll be able to see another video down below my face if you want to see one. I don't know what I'm going to link down there right now, but I'll link you something good. Yeah, and I want to thank you again so much for watching. Mad love, and I'll see you in a video soon. Bye.